When water used indoors hits a drain, it begins its journey to treatment facilities all over Southern Nevada, including those operated by the Clark County Water Reclamation District, which has been recycling our community water every day since 1956.
Up until the 50s, it was a pretty hodgepodge, piecemeal operation. The major resorts on the Strip, they would have their own private treatment facilities. So when the Clark County Water Reclamation District started, we were at the very end of Flamingo Road, where we are today, but this was back in the 50s, so there was nothing out near our plant. And we started with one treatment tank, and now it's grown to the point where our current campus is larger than Disneyland. So as the valley has grown, we've been ahead of the curve, keeping up with preparations to make sure we can help our community thrive. Our role is ensuring that the water used by Las Vegas is recycled. So every drop of water that goes down an interior drain in unincorporated Clark County makes its way here to our plant, where it is treated and then returned to Lake Mead for community use.
To the tune of over 100 million gallons of water each day, which is equivalent to 7,400 average-sized swimming pools. How critical are those gallons?
What's especially exciting about the water we return to Lake Mead is for every gallon we return to the lake, the community is able to take another gallon out. So by playing our role in the water care cycle, we ensure there's that sustainable water supply for our community.
Extended drought along the Colorado River has shrunk Lake Mead, forcing a federally declared water shortage for the first time, requiring reductions to our water supply even further. The technology and infrastructure of the Water Reclamation District, along with its nearly 400 employees, are more important than ever. Its treatment process involves an arsenal of tools, which begins with physical removal and ends with ultraviolet light. The water is then sent to the Las Vegas Wash, where more natural filtration takes place before arriving at Lake Mead to be used again. So we know what we want in the drain, right? And that's water. But explain the things that we don't want going down the drain.
A rule of thumb we say when it comes to remembering what to flush, we say only flush the three P's: pee, poo, and toilet paper. If it's anything else, throw it directly in the trash. And when it comes to your drain, your kitchen sink drain, only put water down there. Don't put your kitchen waste, your food scraps. Yes, it's convenient, but again, that has to go somewhere, and it clogs up pipes that can cause big problems. Another common misconception is people think, oh, the packaging says flushable, therefore I can flush it. And that might technically be true in the sense that if you put golf balls in your toilet and flush them, they're flushable. They will go down, but they still have to go somewhere, and they can cause problems further down in the plumbing system or in our wastewater collection network.
Outdoor water can't be recycled. It escapes into the ground or the atmosphere, so it's extremely important to limit outdoor water use, replace grass with water-smart landscaping, and follow mandatory seasonal watering restrictions.
So with the recently declared water shortage, there's a renewed focus on making sure our water supply is sustainable. And here at the Water Reclamation District, we stand with SNWA and asking Southern Nevadans to reduce and conserve their outdoor water usage. Because every drop of water that goes down a drain inside a building, it comes here to our facility. We can treat that. The water used outdoors, that's lost. That's gone.
Last note, recycling indoor water requires a lot of energy to push that water all around the valley. So conservation, whether you're using less indoor water or outdoor water, is a good thing.